Sure. One of the core messages that I'm trying to get across, though, is that a life where you're in pursuit of wealth is going to be hit with a lot of collateral damage. If you're pursuing happiness, which includes a career, which includes family, which includes your health, you're more likely to be able to achieve all of those things. So you have to be conscious. It doesn't matter whether you got a lot of money or no money. You've got to be conscious of where you want to go. And that's really the essence of why this book is out.
Well, I want to make sure that everybody knows we're taking your calls today. Brett Wilson is here to answer your questions, and we have our lines open right now. So you can call and talk to Brett Wilson, hear his thoughts on how money can change your life, his thoughts on happiness, his thoughts on his time on the den. Our numbers are 1-800-565-1940. That's toll-free anywhere in the Maritimes. If you're in the Halifax area, call us at 420-9336 or send us an email, marnoon@cbc.ca. Let's take our first call from Dave Johnson in Truro. Hi, Dave.
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Thanks for calling in, and welcome to the show. Brett's here to talk to you.
Wonderful. Thanks for taking my call. A pleasure to talk to you, Brett.
Thank you.
You, sir, are a real-life superhero and inspiration with your philanthropy. I often liken you to Bruce Wayne or Tony Stark.
I love Tony Stark. I just put that out there.
So this is a good thing, then.
Thank you. Yes, my question for you, with regards to, naturally, your Tony Stark-like philanthropy, you, of course, have an interesting journey, and I'm looking forward to reading your book. For the average person, like with a mortgage and family and, you know, maybe a lot of bills coming in, what would you recommend as a reasonable percentage to give to charity? I'm curious your thoughts on best ways to give and maybe some of your own favorite charities.
Well, those are all great questions, and that's essentially chapters 8 and 9 in the book, but not here to plug the book, really to have the conversation. Number one, how much? The way I always describe it is I think you should give till it's meaningful. And I always joke and say, once you've decided it's meaningful, if you double it, it'll be meaningful to me as well. And that's really about digging deep. You know, we do a lot of charity events in my home province back in Calgary, and we allow people to bring charity checks that are discretionary. We give a free party, and we ask for what we call a charity check, and people then ask for guidance. And I say, well, given that I'm throwing a dinner and having an event, why don't you throw in what you would have spent on dinner with a family and a fine bottle of wine, and then top it up to the point where it's meaningful. So it's very personal. I mean, no act of charity is too small. I love Mother Teresa's line, and I always jokingly say, no check is too large. So it's really a very personal decision. But the most important thing is that you're thinking about it and engaging. But, you know, more important than money is awareness. To the extent that you can engage friends and family in awareness of a cause, I don't care what it is, that's making a huge difference. Because as an entrepreneur, I always argue that the good causes will be funded. If you don't know about them, they'll never be funded.
Very true.
Anyway, great question.
Great. Thank you very much. Yes, you're the Iron Man of the business world.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you.
How important was your time on Dragon's Den to...